विश यू अ वेरी लवली गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ इंग्लिश क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 10 इन इंग्लिश फर्स्ट एंड चैप्टर 10 इज साइंटिस्ट एनेक्डोट्स। साइंटिस्ट एनेक्डोट्स और चैप्टर नेम इज साइंटिस्ट एनेक्डोट्स। साइंटिस्ट एवरी वन नो एंड एनेक्डोट्स मीन्स अ शॉर्ट अम्यूजिंग और इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी अबाउट अ रियल इंसिडेंट और रियल इंसिडेंट एंड रियल पर्सन। ओके, अ शॉर्ट इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी अबाउट अ रियल इंसिडेंट और पर्सन। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सम साइंटिस्ट। ओके, हेयर आर सम इंटरेस्टिंग एनेक्डोट्स फ्रॉम द लिप्स ऑफ अ फ्यू साइंटिस्ट। जीन लुइस अगासी, आर्किमिडीज, सर फ्रेडरिक ग्रैंट बैंटिंग एंड होमी भाभा। फर्स्ट स्टोरी इज जीन लुइस अगासी। हिज बर्थ ईयर 1807 एंड डाइड ईयर 1873। ही वॉज अ स्विस अमेरिकन नेचुरलिस्ट, जियोलॉजिस्ट एंड टीचर। ही मेड सिग्निफिकेंट contribution to the study of fish forms and knowledge about ice glaciers. His first work on fishes was published when he was only 22 years old. And story is real story. He was once out traveling with some friends and stopped at a place for refreshment. Okay, he stopped at a place for refreshment. An elderly traveler was also passing by and hearing the name of Agassiz mentioned, came over to the young man who had been addressed by that name. Pardon me, but are you the son of the celebrated Professor Agassiz of Neuchâtel? He asked. Agassiz merely smiled. Okay, that time he asked to Agassiz, then Agassiz that time merely smiled, and before he could say anything, one of his friends remarked, "You are standing before Professor Agassiz himself." The traveler moved away with an apology, murmuring to himself, "Such a modest young body for such a wise old head." It is a story of Jean Louis Agassiz. It is a real story, and second scientist is Archimedes. His date of birth year 287 BC before Christ, and died year 212 before Christ. Okay, and Archimedes was a Greek mathematician, physicist, and inventor who made numerous original contributions in mathematics and geometry. His inventions were mainly mechanical devices that were used in war and later in peace. When we name him, we immediately form the figure of a man running naked on the street, crying, "Irukka, irukka." Okay, I have found it. Its meaning: it was when he had, while lying in the bathtub, formulated the principle that a body immersed in a fluid is buoyed up by a force equal to the weight of the displaced fluid. Okay, yeah, so he is also very great scientist, very great mathematician, So once King Hiron asked Archimedes to devise new weapons when the Romans were threatening to attack his native city, Syracuse. On learning that a Roman fleet had set sail under Marcellus Airfield, Roman commander, Archimedes turned to the king and said, "I believe I can destroy the fleet." Okay, then it is a story. Archimedes' life, it is a real story. And next, our next scientist is Sir Frederick Grant Banting. Okay, Sir Frederick Grant Banting, his birth year 1891 and died year 1941. Banting was a Canadian medical scientist who shared the Nobel Prize in 1923 for his medicinal research in extracting the insulin hormone from the pancreas. He joined the army during the Second World War to serve his country when he was as old as 49. He was described as a stubborn man. Okay, he was described as a stubborn man. And once he was lying in hospital after being injured badly in the Battle of Cambrai. His arm had been shot and there was no chance of saving it. "We must operate you immediately," said the army doctor to Banting. Then it is a conversation and a real story. You are in this chapter, all scientists give the real story, short real story. And "we must operate you immediately," said the army doctor to Banting. "You are not going to take my arm away from me," replied Banting. Then, "Not if I can help it," said the doctor, "but we must amputate my boy, otherwise we may not be able to save your life." "Oh no, not my arm. I will risk the chance of dying," Banting said these words and turned on his side. Fortunately, he risked his chance and lived. 6 years later, he received the Nobel Prize for Medicine. Our next scientist, Homi Bhabha. Homi Bhabha. And Homi Bhabha was an Indian atomic physicist. He is regarded as the father of independent India's scientific ethos and its nuclear program. He set up with the encouragement of the then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru a prestigious center for research in nuclear physics, which later came to be known as the Bhabha Atomic Research Center, BARC, BARC. Okay, Bhabha Atomic Research Center. This research center Homi Bhabha named. Okay, more than anything else, he is remembered for his unwavering commitment to science and the great hopes he had for the future of science in India. His contribution in planning the center is tremendous, but what is little known is his role in designing the landscape in and around the center. While planning the roads, he observed that an ancient mango tree stood at that very spot where a road was to pass. The civil engineer in charge of building the roads had recommended that the old tree be uprooted so that a straight road could be built. This greatly distressed Baba. He strongly felt that the tree, which had lived at the place for more than a 100 years, had every right to be there. After giving the problem a great deal of attention, he suggested a real realignment of the road in exact civil engineering terms in order to save the tree. Today the tree is still there, okay? This mango tree today also is still there, old and ancient, like a living monument.